Hi everybody, I'm Bree the Plant Lady, and today I am going to start fertilizing. And I thought that this would be a good opportunity for me to share some of my favorite products that I use in my garden. And before anybody decides to write some snotty comment, I am not trying to sell you anything, okay? I don't get paid to do this. I'm just sharing practical information with you to help make your gardening experience as good as possible. All right, now that that's out of the way, let's talk about fertilizer, because I like to fertilize everything in my garden once in March and again in October. And unless I'm just planting, like, you know, annuals at different times of the year, then I'll give them a little batch of fertilizer upon planting. But for the most part, really just fertilize March and October. And I always use organic fertilizer. And that's because I believe very strongly in feeding the soil. When you have a healthy development of microbial activity in your soil, you will ultimately have stronger plants. So those plants will develop deeper root systems. They will be able to ward off problem insects and problem diseases, and it'll be an easier gardening experience for you. And I also recommend that when you use fertilizer, you always get NPK numbers that are lower than 15. So, you know, a lot of times if you're using a synthetic fertilizer, you might get 20-20-20. Almost no plant needs to have that ratio. They're not going to absorb all of that, and a lot of it's just going to wash off in rain and ultimately get into water systems. So it's another reason to just stick with organic, because the plants will absorb these lower ratios of NPK. Now, a fertilizer that's new to me this year that I'm really excited about using is this one that I got from Johnny Appleseed. And this is unique because it's made without any animal parts. So I don't have any experience with this yet, but it's a 444. So this is really exactly what I'm looking for at this time of year, to give all of my plants the boost they need without having them push too much new growth, just in case we have, you know, nights that get below freezing. So we're only in the middle of March, it's entirely possible. We are still a month away from our frost-free date here in Zone 7, Central North Carolina. So I'm looking forward to putting this out. Of course, I have a huge garden. This isn't gonna cover everything that I'm growing. So I have my old standby garden tone. I like to use this on, you know, all of my annual vegetables and herbs, really flowers. It's a great all-purpose fertilizer. You can't go wrong using Espoma products. I also use holly tone on my acid-loving plants, things like blueberries, camellias, hydrangeas, gardenias, hollies. Okay. Cottonseed meal. I don't know if you're familiar with this, but this is a product that I started using when I moved to North Carolina. This is a high ratio of nitrogen. This is a 6-1-1 analysis. I don't like to use cottonseed until May, but I wanted to show you that this is a product that I use, especially for planting my summer crops. Things like corn and tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, basil, all those things that are gonna go into the ground a couple months from now. I like to give them just a little bit of this cottonseed meal as just a big boost of nitrogen, but only on planting, because throughout the rest of the season, you need to make sure that you're giving your plants an equal rotation of nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus to ensure that you're gonna get good root development, strong stem growth, and fruit that will ultimately be what you harvest. Okay, what about the bugs? We are getting into the season of cabbage worms. I've already had a few broccoli plants get completely devoured, and I'm a strong believer in using BT. This is a powder BT. BT is Bacillus thuringiensis. It's a biological insecticide. It's organic safe. Basically, you powder this over your plants, and when the caterpillars eat it, they get full and they die, and that's the goal. Remember, cabbage worms aren't pollinators, okay? We gotta have a discussion at some point over being rational about understanding the difference between a pest and a pollinator, and there are some things that we need to take into consideration. You can also get this as a liquid form. I've just always been in the habit of using the powder because then I see that it's applied, and if it rains and washes off, I'm reminded that I need to reapply it. This gets used the entire time that I have brassicas in my garden, so that's all of spring and all of fall. Now, two other products that I want to show you. Oh. One thing about fertilizing is a good way to get in shape because these bags are really heavy. So if you have drainage issues, or if you want to zone bend and grow something that may not really want to live where you live, or if you have vole issues, Permatil is the magic ingredient. This is like expanded shale, and it's just altogether a really useful product. Unfortunately, I cannot find it online. So if you don't live in the Southeast, what I'd recommend is asking at a local independent garden center to get them to start carrying this, because everybody everywhere could benefit from having this product. But I think right now it's not mass distributed, but it should be. Now another product. Oh, just showing you how out of shape I am. Oh. For increasing drainage, also acidifying your soil, is the soil conditioner. And this is just ground aged pine bark. And you really can't go wrong incorporating this into your soil or even using it as a top dress or mulch. I know I've done videos showing how I use this, and you can actually find this at box stores, so this is pretty readily available. I hope this video will help guide you in your process of buying products this spring, and I am wishing you all the best in this coming growing season. Happy gardening!